What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to another video. In today's video, we're gonna be working on the 7 Series. So, again, this car is an endless piece of work. We have so many things to still fix on this car and so many things to still do. The bumper, I cannot find anybody selling a bumper less than $1,000, and that's without paint. Like, $1,000, and it's really beat up and needs paint. That is more than my M4 bumper. That is ridiculous. So, we are taking our time on the bumper. As for the headlight, we did find a headlight with an adaptive headlight issue. I'm hoping that's just a module. So we're gonna go ahead and get the headlight down here, put it on the car. Definitely gonna replace the cracked one at least. And it has every other module, so it should take away a lot of the errors as long as we figure out that adaptive issue. And maybe we can take parts out of this one to fix the other one, because this adaptive actually works. We're gonna have to figure that out. We're gonna have to hop back into this car, check out the errors and stuff like that. We do have a lot of other things we also need to do with this car. But before we actually get into the car, the next slide is dedicated to you guys that purchase merch to support your boy and support the 7 Series. These are limited edition merch, and you guys have been absolutely destroying it. I think literally face masks are nearly sold out. As for the plates, we do have, I think, less than half left, but still, that's less than half. And once they're sold out, they're sold out. I'm not gonna be restocking on these anytime soon. But yeah, again, for everyone that cops up to support the channel, this next part is dedicated to you guys. Thank you all so much. And you guys will be seeing your names hopefully on the 7 Series plaque once it's made. So yeah, guys, if you guys haven't copped your plates or your face masks just yet, make sure to check out that link down below. Face masks are nearly sold out, and these plates are also very nearly sold out. Face masks are literally almost gone, so make sure to cop those. And I just really just want to take 1 second to really thank you guys so much. I mean, I don't know if you guys know, but as moving into a new place and dealing with all these BMWs and the registration on the M4 is nearly $2,200 alone, I am at that point in my life where my credit card is at negative. Like, it's that bad right now, because there's a lot of financial things I have to do to just situate my life. There's a lot of things coming up, even school starting, so I gotta pay up the tuition in about 8 days. So things are getting a little bit rough for me. I really appreciate all of you guys who are copying merch and supporting your man, because I honestly would not be able to continue doing fun stuff like this on top of school and life. So I really do appreciate you guys. Once we get situated in a new home, you guys will definitely be getting a full tour of the house. And then hopefully when I finish college, I'll be dedicating so much more time to you guys. So again, thank you guys so much for the constant support. Literally, I was just talking to my fiance about how I can't even afford to register the M4. And you guys literally yesterday bought so much merch, and you guys literally got me to be able to have the cash to be able to register the M4. Hopefully you guys will be seeing that in the next video. So again, thank you guys so much for that. Speaking of M4, we do have the AC cans right here. So we have the AC cans right there. We also have this bad boy here to pump it in. So once the M4 is here, we should be able to have AC. Also, shout out to Straight Six Auto Parts for this guy right here. I think this is the wheel guard for the front of the M4, the side that was hit. So the driver's side, I mean the passenger side. So I actually needed this. I actually have the rear portion. It's basically the wheel guards that go right here. So the rear portion on both sides, I have them for the M4, but I don't have neither front, and they had the passenger front. So thankfully they did send it out. Shout out to them. All I had to do is pay shipping. Their Instagram is being linked down below. They part out so many cars and they sell a whole bunch of parts for them. So if you guys want to check them out, check them out. Huge shout out to them for supporting the build and sending this out. Again, if you guys need any parts for your cars, especially N54s, they got so many. All right, let's just crack this little puppy open. I just want to see what exactly we got. This is an OEM splash shield. This is gonna fit so perfectly in the M4. Let me go show you guys the other part that we have. This is the rear one for the passenger side, the rear front, and this is the front for the passenger side. So now we're complete. We are just missing this little door here. Not a big deal. At least we got everything else now for the passenger side. So we just need the front for the driver's side. If any of you guys have that, let me know down below. That's the last piece we need to button up the car. And we just have some small grills. I have an image right here. We need those two small grills for the front bumper. But other than that, I think we're looking pretty good. All right, guys, this is not an M4 video. This is a 7 Series video, so let's hop in the car again and just check out what kind of errors we have. And we need to put the car in a jumper because I don't want the battery to die. It's already bad as it is. All right, guys, coming around to the interior. You guys know that we already replaced a couple things around here in the car just to make it, you know, just more beautiful. And we found out we have other issues like our cruise control and our clock spring is shot. But other than that, we're running into some good news here and there. Not that our windshield and our transmission shot, but other than that, also, we have some good news. Wow, this is never gonna end. There's just so many errors with this car, it's not even funny. We have the rear sensors now. Let's go ahead and just replace the rear sensors, so we're good to go on that. And our brake pads are already pretty good, so we just need to replace the sensor itself and we should be good to go. So let's go and get that done. Here is our new brake sensor. Let's go and get that wheel off and install the new bad boy. This is looking fresh. At this point, guys, let's go ahead and try to clear or reset the brake light, and hopefully that should fix our issue. Now wait for all the lights to pop up, guys. Literally have to wait about 30 seconds to a minute for all the lights to come up, then we can start using the car, because we can't actually access anything until all this is popped up. So actually, for those of you guys who don't know actually how to reset your car without Carly or some kind of special adapter, you can actually do it from right here. Your service intervals and everything can be reset from right here on your car. All you have to do is put the car in accessory mode, and then you hold down this button right here, that little weird little button here in the bottom left. You hold it there until that screen comes up. So we go ahead and hold it again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Bada bing, bada bang. And then now you can go ahead and click the BC button to, I think you hold it. Bada bing, please. Reset unsuccessful. Ah, man, okay. All right, guys, so we tried resetting it from here, it didn't work. What we did last time, we did it on the computer. The reason being is I think this is it has a very, very old software, and it just doesn't work properly at all right now. So we are gonna be updating the software pretty soon. Let me hit up Nick and see if he has any free time to help us clear this light. But for the meantime, washer fluid low, okay, right turn signal, battery charge level low, power window anti-trap. That just came up out of nowhere. I'm assuming that's because of the battery. TPMS, keep having an issue with that. I'm pretty sure all my wheels do have TPMS though, so we're gonna have to try to figure out how to calibrate that later. I really wanna murder out this entire car, but also bring back all the BMW emblems. Like you guys saw, he put like some kind of black emblem here. I brought back the BMW emblem here, because BMW emblems, you don't want a black guy. You wanna keep them BMW. On all the wheels, there are these ugly, ugly center caps, and they're barely even holding on in there. So we're gonna wanna replace all these center caps. I wanna paint all these wheels black. I wanna pretty much wrap all this trim black. I pretty much wanna get it super, super, super clean looking, clean up all the tires, black out the wheels. Hopefully we'll be doing that in the next video. That is my next goal. Put a new emblem here, because what is that? New emblem in the rear. So when we have the wheels off, we're gonna be checking everything, but I mean, I'm pretty sure you can tell, yeah, this has a TPMS sensor in it. This is hard. You can definitely tell there's a TPMS sensor there. This one also has a TPMS sensor. This one also has a TPMS sensor, and this one also. So looks like definitely a battery issue. It keeps saying resetting. It will not actually set. Definitely a battery issue. Once we get the battery set, hopefully, because it's saying our window isn't working, and it's clearly working just fine. So this car is throwing a lot of faults because of the battery. We do need a new battery. It's just the batteries are like $200. I'm trying to find a good deal on something, because this car, oh man, we spent so much money and it's not worth this much, but we're still gonna be saving it. Don't worry, guys. Still the goal. A bunch of errors again for the two headlights in the front. Increased battery discharge, probably because the headlights aren't even connected. Transmission, again, malfunction, seat calibration, headlight vertical aim control. Okay. So we are waiting on the modules for the headlights. We did order those. We did order the other headlight. So we're waiting on that as well. I can't wait till we get a bumper so the car just looks at least complete, and we can work with all the little bells and whistles, but at least the car looks like a decent car altogether. And that's also why I wanna paint all the wheels and change all the emblems, because those things look so bad. As soon as you paint the wheels, it's gonna really transform the car. And as soon as you put all new emblems on here, it's gonna look really good. Like already the interior looks a lot better with the OEM logo on there, fixing up all the little buttons here and there. This piece is also still coming in the mail. Hopefully we get that done in the next video. This we're gonna be replacing, and obviously the dash as well. So obviously we got a lot of things to do, but enough talking nor. I think the next thing on our list is to check the valve cover gasket. So we do have all the emblems here for the wheels and everything. Literally the whole kit right here. This is from Amazon. I have a link down below if you guys want this kit. This looks like an OEM kit. Yeah, so it looks really, really, really good. This video is sponsored again by FCP Euro. So we do have the windshield wipers, which we're not gonna be replacing in this video, mainly because this windshield is cracked, and I don't know if it's gonna really affect it going. Actually, just maybe right here might affect this one. But other than that, I mean, we could replace it. They're gonna have to remove it anyways once again to replace the windshield. We do need a new windshield. I was wanting to remove this little tin here because it just looks so bad. But I mean, what's the point of going through the hassle if we're gonna replace the whole windshield anyway? So meantime, we do have new spark plugs. Yes, we have 8, 2 for spares, 6 to put in the car, 6 ignition coils, Bosch, you guys already know. Again, all from FCP Euro, lifetime warranty. So if any of these ever go bad, bad, we can send it back, get another one for free. Any of these go bad, we can send it back, get another one for free. You guys know that we've already replaced the oil filter housing gasket and the oil filter gasket. So we already replaced these two gaskets and actually the oil filter housing gasket. We replaced all the gaskets in this area right here. I don't know if you guys can tell, but yeah, all this, no leaks, looks super good. Our only issue is now is checking the valve cover gasket, because again, I'm trying to perfect this car literally to the bare bones. So we're gonna go ahead and remove this beauty cover right now, and I replace all the ignition coils, all the spark plugs, check in each single cylinder, and check if we have any oil in this cylinder or any oil around here from a valve cover leak. So let's go ahead and look into it, and hopefully we have no leaks in the top end, so we just have to deal with the leaks in the bottom end. We have some severe leaks on the bottom end. Hopefully no more leaks on the top end. Yeah, know what? It looks like we also have a valve cover gasket leak. Not really surprised, I would say. Looking in here, guys, honestly, there's a little bit of fresh oil spill, but I think that's because of me. Other than that, actually looks really good in here. Let me show you guys. So looking around here, you can see some fresh oil right there, and that's right next to this. That's probably me. I probably dumped it. Other than that, if you guys look over here, it looks really good. If you guys look down here, no fresh oil whatsoever. So from what I'm seeing, it doesn't look like we are leaking in the valve cover, but then again, we'll find out when we actually take out the spark plugs. So let's go ahead and take out the spark plugs and see if we got a valve cover leak here. Guys, looking at our ignition coils, the only two that were wet were these two right here. It had a little bit of oil on there, and I'm clearly thinking that's because I dropped oil right next to it. Just go ahead and just clean up the area where these ignition coils went, and which was right here. This is pretty much where the oil spill was. If I can clean all that out, we'll go ahead and remove all the spark plugs. If this is the only two that's just a little bit dosed in oil, then I'll be fine with that. But if these are also drops in oil, that means you might have a valve cover leak. But honestly, guys, I'm really doubting it just because I'm not seeing anything anywhere around, and I'm only seeing it literally right underneath the cap right there. So let's go ahead and just clean this up as much as we can and then go and get these spark plugs out. All right, guys, so we sucked up all the oil from out in here, and honestly, I'm thinking the valve cover is just perfect. I think it's already been replaced. It looks really good in my opinion. Let's go ahead and pull out the spark plugs and we'll know for sure. I'm actually using this tool from Keys Motorsports. Again, link down below. This is a spark plug tool with an extension and a swivel all built in, and it even has a magnet. So this should work on this car. I think this works on every BMW, I'm not too sure. Because E90s, the 335s, and the 328s, the 335 is, you guys barely have any room, and then the 328s, you have a lot of room. So let's go ahead and just see if this tool will work. I'll let y'all know in a second. Guys, so in terms of oil, these two had oil in it. This one was drenched in oil, but this one again was right underneath the oil, the actual oil filler. So I feel like that should be because of that, and it was fresh new oil. So I feel like that could be because of that. It doesn't look like it's been there for a little bit either. Like I'm telling you guys, it was so clear oil. You guys didn't even see, these are burnt. But they don't look that bad either, to be honest. So I'm having high hopes that the actual valve cover is good. As for these are all pretty good. I'm actually gonna save all these. As for these, they don't look too good, so you might even just junk them. But we got a full new set from FCPR for that lifetime warranty on this car. So anyways, if we ever have a problem with any of these, we can send it back to FCP, get a free replacement. I love FCPR, shout out to them. Links down below if you guys need any maintenance or anything at all for your BMWs. They have literally every single BMW. Without further ado, let's go ahead and install these spark plugs. Alright guys, ignition coils and spark plugs all set, all looking good. I even didn't forget to plug in that fuel injector we unplugged. Guys, this tool is amazing, mainly because whenever we pull out the spark plug, this piece doesn't come off, so it stays all together and it's magnetic, so you can easily come in and out. This tool helped me get this job done literally like probably 15-20 minutes. So shout out to Keys-Mosos for this amazing tool. I think I've only seen this by them. So if you guys want a cool all-in-one spark plug tool, make sure to check out Keys Motorsports. Again, link down below. I gotta head out, so I'll see you guys in about a few hours, probably when it's a lot darker. And guys, your man is back after about 6 hours. Had to help out my fiance's family with a few things, and now we are finally back at the garage. And we're back where we left off. We're pretty much, you know, the car's chilling like a villain. Currently, we did install all new 6 ignition coils and all new 6 spark plugs from FCP Euro, Bosch branded, which is really good stuff. Again, lifetime warranty. We did the gaskets and everything, which is great. And then we also replaced the cabin, the intake air filter, the cabin air filters. So in terms of everything here, I'm pretty happy about it. Let's just go ahead and install everything back once again. Hopefully we're gonna have no issues. Hopefully everything should be good to go. We even replaced this filter, the ring and everything. Like literally from this top end, other than the belt, we pretty much have done everything, which is really good. So in terms of the front end, we could pretty much start cleaning all this stuff, making it look really pretty. Obviously we need to get a bumper on here, a headlight. It's gonna need some more of alignments and stuff like that. So it is gonna get a little bit more dirty down here, but for the most part, it does need a good cleaning. So we might just go with a general wipe down, but without further ado, let's just first put this thing together. I mean, it is so satisfying when you guys do maintenance. It's kind of like that preventative maintenance, because you're kind of like, okay, we are good forever. We are good for another 60,000 miles, 80,000 miles. We are ready to go. So without further ado, we're going to set you guys up and just put this stuff back together. One day soon. Alright guys, so we finally got everything reassembled, and like I said, we've pretty much been working on this front end, like all the gaskets and everything in terms of maintenance. So in terms of the front end, everything is pretty much done, but since it looks so ugly, I feel like it just nothing's been completed. So let's go ahead and clean up our work and just clean up all this good stuff here, just so the whole engine bay looks spot and clean, because we did all our work there. Might as well at least get the gratification that everything's been properly done, so properly clean, you know what I mean? So yeah, here's the before, and about to show you guys the after. This engine bay is looking so much cleaner. I think I'm gonna give the hood just a quick little wipe down. I probably should do that first, because it is also very disgusting. I feel like every time I close it and open it, a lot of dirt's gonna come down. So let me go ahead and just give this a quick little wipe down. This is how you do it. Man, oh my god, now it looks like we did some severe maintenance. Look at that, look at this engine bay, guys, looking so much better. Obviously that stuff back there, it's gonna be an absolute pain to clean, that little kind of like it's kind of like, it feels like cloth. It's really weird. More like cotton, actually. And it's super hard to clean. You probably have to pull all those out and like deep clean them. But other than that, all the plastics and everything, all the hoses for the most part are looking really good. And like we said, guys, we replaced all the gaskets in this area. The valve cover, in my opinion, is good to go. I think it's been replaced previously in its lifetime. We replaced the air filter here, all the spark plugs, all the ignition coils. And I believe these are running index 12s in terms of ignition fuel injectors. So I think we're good on that. So in terms of the engine bay up top, we're good to go. In terms of the bottom, I pretty much put a bigger screw in there because the screw was stripped and it looks like he used a self-tapping screw, and I tried to reuse his self-tapping screw and it stripped the bigger screw, so he put even a bigger screw. So that's not really ideal for the next person. You know, this could be something that's like, oh, I don't even have to tell you guys. I could have just done it off camera. You'd button the car together, and if I was to sell the car, you know, I'd sell it and be like, you know, it's the next person's problem. But, you know, the person that did that to me, obviously I'm not happy with that. And imagine the next person I do it to, I can imagine if he doesn't know anything about BMWs, he knows he is in for a big treat, and that is no fun. An oil pan gasket and an oil pan on this car, if you don't know what you're doing, you have to take it to the dealer, is a lot of money. So obviously for me, I've only done an oil pan once with the supervision of my friend that works at BMW, and he honestly did pretty much the whole job. I was just there and I got the experience and all, and it's a lot of work. It's very, very intuitive, and you really have to, it's a very hands-on job. But anywho, we're gonna have to replace that oil pan gasket, because once you replace the oil pan gasket, everything from the front end in terms of motor and everything, we shouldn't have any oil leaks. Everything should be perfect. And then we just have to deal with the transmission situation. So either we're gonna have to get a whole new Megatronics or a whole new transmission, because we have a leak between our engine and transmission. I don't know if it's because of something else, but I'm pretty sure it's the rear main seal. So in terms of the transmission, I'm just gonna look out again for a good deal. Everyone's trying to sell me a transmission for $2,000. And you know, for a car bait $3,300 for, I'm not spending $2,000 on a transmission, I can tell you that. I'm even on the lookouts for a parts car, one with a blown motor, and just try to get the rest of the car so we can start swapping out a whole bunch of parts, make it perfect, and then use the other car, part it out for somebody else's 7 Series. But let me know, guys, in the next video, should I actually take off these wheels for now, sand it all down, clean up the wheels, pretty much spray paint these wheels black, replace the center caps with BMW center caps, and I feel like that'll make a huge difference on the side of the car. And also, I mean, it's gonna make it all of a difference throughout the entire car. It's gonna look so good. Let me know down below if you guys wanna see that. And let me know if any of you guys can find a bumper under $500. If any of you guys can find a bumper anywhere, even on eBay, please link it down below. $500, preferably black, obviously, so we don't have to pay for paint. Because we already have to paint the rear bumper, you have to paint the fender, you have to paint the rear quarter panel. There's a lot of little things that need to get paint and touched up. So we're probably gonna take it down to the paint shop and be like, just give us a quote to repair these three little spots. Probably like $200-$300. I'm hoping, honestly, I'm really hoping that's the price. Because if he's gonna say, because of that small little fender issue, $200 to repaint this and fix this, I'll be like, oh my God, I really hope that's just a cheap touch-up. And these lines right here, these are giant scratches that I actually didn't see. I thought that was dirt. And last but not least, this paint fade. I don't know if you guys can see it, but it's really bad. Like, all this is paint faded, but that's it. I mean, the rest of the bumper is in perfect shape. I'm pretty sure you can paint this and just blend it. Shouldn't take too much work. And since we're also getting that fender done and we're also getting that rear quarter panel done, I feel like that's considered a full job, and he might just charge us $200 because he just has to touch up three little areas. So I hope we should be good on that. And of course, we're gonna need a front bumper. If I can't find it in black, we'll just paint the whole front bumper. But I really, really, really am looking for this front bumper, because once you have a front bumper on this car, it's gonna not look like a totaled car. It's okay if the transmission doesn't go in park, but as long as the car doesn't look like it's totaled, we can drive it, we can feel happy about it. But right now, I don't even feel like driving this because it literally looks like, pull me over, my car is messed up, it is not street legal. Honestly, guys, I have nothing else for this video. I mean, I honestly have nothing. I don't think I have anything else that's here for this video. We do have the emblems. This is the only thing I do have on hand. I'm still waiting on a few other things, but I guess since we have the emblems, we might as well do it. So we have the front and rear. I think these are gonna make a big difference. Let me show you guys how bad this front emblem is. Like, what is this, guys? It doesn't even look like a BMW. Imagine we slap that on it. It's gonna make all of a difference. So 3, 2, 1. And bada bing, guys, the hood is super filthy. But I mean, come on, this looks so much better. Yeah, we need to wash the car. It's definitely terrible. It's kind of dark out right now, but hopefully in the next video when we do the wheels. But hey guys, finally I'm super, super, super happy about this M1 mix. Literally the whole front end from at least here look a lot better. Car is super dirty though, but it is what it is. All right, we're gonna have to replace that one too. Oh my God, I really, like look how yellow it is. I mean, just take a look at it. And RIP, the rear one on this car apparently is a lot bigger, so I think this is an 82. What size is this thing? This thing is huge. Yeah, it looks like the front and rear on this car is the same. So this is about an 82 millimeter in the rear as well. That's crazy. So anyway, I mean, better to put something than nothing, but oh my God, this hurts. Ugh. Disgusting. All right guys, well unfortunately that is all I have for the 7 series as of today, but I'm super, super, super happy with everything we have done to this car so far. I know it's been a short video, I know guys, and it's been about 3 days. I'm hoping by the end of this month things should be able to get back on pace with my life. It's just, again, I'm spending a lot of time trying to get the new house situated, and that's off camera, and that's just because it's just trying to give my fiance her privacy and things like that. Once I'm actually ready, when she's ready to come on the channel, then I'll show you guys a lot of my personal life as well. I don't want to force her into something that, you know, she has no business in right now. I don't want to be like, hey, here's a camera in your face. You know, that's very uncomfortable. I hope you guys can see where I'm coming from. So I'm just trying to manage that part of my life right now. I'm just trying to get everything situated inside the house, and then I'm also trying to bring you guys some content when I can. Hopefully in the next video, guys, it will be some pretty much a new look in the entire 7 series. I mean, probably the next video is not going to be the 7 series. The next video is getting the M4 back from the body shop. Yes, so that's gonna be really exciting. Hopefully getting the car back from the body shop, painted and everything. Probably even registered plates on and all that good stuff. So again, if you guys are ready for that, make sure to smash the like button. But again, thank you guys so much for constantly supporting the channel. Remember guys, we're pretty much almost sold out on both of these. So especially the face masks, I think we're literally last, maybe like 10 or 15 left, that's it. So yeah, thank you guys for understanding. By the end of this month, I anticipate I should have everything situated with the house, and I should be able to get back to my normal thing and just start, you know, pumping out videos left and right. School is starting, but I'll figure it out. I'll figure it out for you guys because I love y'all so much. Without further ado guys, I love y'all so much. Remember to stay humble. I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace out. I'm telling you guys, my neighbors be like, why is this dude yelling in his garage at like 10 at night? I mean, you gotta do what you gotta do, you know?